artistic. He can't formulate his thoughts and feelings in words. And there's no substitute for the autistic child. No braille, no sign language. No language at all which can reach him in his solitary world. No human language. It's as if he were isolated on an island off the coast of human knowing, and there is no boat, no bridge to carry him across the sound. Science can offer no explanation for Michael's handicap, but then there's so much that science can't explain.
Exactly what's wrong, Paul?
Dr. Hoffman, I'm going to have to replace the whole damn thing.
Well, how long will that take?
A couple of hours, at least.
Oh, damn.
Unless you want to go with only one.
No, just hold on, Paul. I'm coming. Danielle, will you answer that, please?
Interspecies Communication Research.
Hi, Danielle.
Jeff.
Yeah, listen, I'm having a bad time with Michael.
Jeff! Jeff!
Here, I'm sorry, Danielle.
Look, it looks like we're going to be a couple of hours replacing an underwater cable, so take your time.
Okay, I'll be there as soon as I can.
Jeremy's just coming in. Do you want to...
No, just give the message, okay?
All right,
thanks, bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, who was that?
Jeff. He's having trouble with Michael. I told him not to rush.
It's just one thing after another. I don't see how we're going to meet the application deadline if things keep breaking
down.
There's
not much we can do here until he arrives.
Mm.
Why don't you come to the pool with me? We'll spend some time with your dolphins.
Oh, what the hell, eh? Hold him, Miriam. We don't have all day.
Dad, I'm trying. What do you think I'm doing? Playing with him?
Don't be smart with me. Grab his shoulders.
Daddy's just putting on your helmet, Michael. We're going to see the dolphins. The dolphins, Michael. He likes the dolphins.
Damn this buckle. There. All right. Miriam, did you put everything you need in the car?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. Come on, Michael. Come on. Up you go.
Here
you go.
Okay, Michael. Okay. Look, there's the car. We're just going to get in the car.
I don't think they want you to leave just yet, huh?
That's right, you guys. Laugh it up.
Come on. Here's your towel, ma'am.
Oh, thank you, sir. Those three sure are playful today.
Yeah. You know, it's better than the dark mood they were in yesterday when the computer terminal broke down, huh? Oh. Have you been watching Jeff Simon this year? No, he doesn't take his eyes off him.
Yeah, I always thought autistic kids didn't have that long an attention span.
Well, they don't usually, except for self-stimulation. But, well, I don't know. Michael really seems to be focusing on the dolphins. Hmm. Well, I've been meaning to discuss it with Jeff, but there just never seems to be enough time to sit down with him and really
Jeremy,
get to...
Jeremy, I need to talk to you about something.
Well, go ahead.
Do you ever get... frightened by them?
What, the dolphins? No.
Something happened last week.
Well, I'm listening.
Well, you remember when I...
Hmm?
Well, it was the day I managed to get them to do that synchronized over and under pattern down
the
pool.
Yeah, now that was something. I still don't know how you managed it, but...
I don't know either.
Oh, I see.
Do you? Jeremy, when I'm in the water with them, I feel almost... I don't know how to say it. It's like I'm hollow inside. And, well, that day I went into the pool thinking, visualizing what I wanted them to do. And then I felt something, and they were just looking at me, and they just went and did it. After months of trying to figure out how to teach them, with no signal or anything from me, they just
Danielle, went... Danielle, what you felt is the reason we're doing all this.
I'm not sure I understand.
Well, look, why do you think I constantly put my reputation on the line to get funding for this project? All of this equipment and the resources, the research, and hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of technology, it's all to try to make sense out of what you and I and others have felt.
You?
Yeah, well, actually, you've just joined a very exclusive club, huh? Well, don't forget, Danielle, before you came here, I was the one in the water with them.
Oh, I guess I just thought
it's not an easy thing to talk about, is it? Yeah, but we have to be careful not to jeopardize the project by saying too much about what we feel. Some of my colleagues are ready to jump on me at the first sign. Mm. Well, now you know why it's become the most important thing in my life right now. To find a way, a language to reach these dolphins and somehow let them reach us.
But I thought we were always supposed to decide things together.
Miriam, calm down and listen to me.
It's not fair. Why didn't you tell me?
I just got the call yesterday. I'm telling you now.
You knew about it before. You knew you were going to put him away.
I'm not putting him away.
Yes, you are.
Miriam, stop it. Now you got Michael off on Miriam, listen to me. His name has been on the waiting list for 6 months. He has to go now. Or maybe never.
He was getting better.
He is getting worse. Did he bang his head last year the way he does now? Huh?
No.
No. Does he look at us? Does he talk? Does he have fewer tantrums?
I still don't see why you have to send him away.
Because Michael is autistic. He's going to be autistic for the rest of his life. Now, you know that.
Mom said he'd only get better if we took care of him. Mom says we're the only ones who can...
Mom is dead. We have to give him up for a while. If we keep him with us all the time, we may do him more harm than good.
You're sending him away because you're so busy all the time.
Now, you know that that's not true. We just don't know how to give Michael what he needs. If he depends on us for everything all his life, well, that's no good. What if something happened to me or you? And you're going to want a life of your own. You're not going to want to spend your whole life...
I'll take care of him for as long as I have to. I don't care what you...
This is Michael's last chance, Miriam. Do you want him to be the way he is now for the rest of his life?
Daddy, stop it.
Now, listen to me. That school in Toronto is the best in the country. And I'm not going to let this opportunity for Michael slip away. Aunt Esther is going to take him there in a couple of days.
No!
Miriam! You'll be out of school in less than 3 months. And by that time, I'll be finished the project at the center. We'll go to Toronto. At least for the summer, and if I can find work there, we'll stay. And we can visit Michael all the time.
It won't be the same.
No, it won't. We're just going to have to get used to living without him for a while. Come on, honey. Come on, it's all right. It's okay, come on. That's it. We're not going to let anything bad happen to him. Okay?
That's right. Here, take this. You gonna be okay, honey? Huh? I need you today.
Yes.
I've got a lot of work to do, and I really need you to take care of him.
Okay.
Okay. Come on, let's get him unbuckled.
Had to go back to school, back to Vancouver.
What happened?
The paper said that some of the people in town saw the dolphin looking for him along the beach, where they used to meet. Then about a month later, they found the dolphin. He was dead on the sand.
You were right. It is a sad story. Paul, how much longer?
Couple of minutes. We're just running a check on it now.
Danielle.
What, honey?
Can you actually talk to the dolphins?
Oh, well, sort of.
I think Michael can talk their language. A little, anyway.
He what?
Haven't you heard him? When he's sitting beside the pool. He makes noises like them. I've even heard him do it at home.
Well, I think he echoes a lot of what he hears. That doesn't mean
he... used to be able to talk.
Really?
When he was about 1.5.
I didn't know that.
Then he got autistic.
Well, maybe someday he'll be able to...
Excuse me, Danielle. I'm just on my way to lower the spheres into the pool, if you want to tell the boss.
Thanks, Paul. Jeremy? Jeff?
Here.
We're lowering in the spheres.
All right. We'll let you know when we're ready. I'm just putting my intro down on tape.
Okay.
What are the spheres for?
What? Oh, they're part of the experiment.
How's it work?
Well, those 5 spheres look exactly the same, even underwater. But they're different in weight, because they're all partly hollow, some less and some more. The dolphins have to tell them apart.
How?
With their sonar.
Dad told me about that, but I still don't understand it.
They bounce very high-pitched sonar clicks off objects, and they get information by the way the sounds come back. It's sort of like if you threw pebbles against different things. If it's metal, you get one kind of sound, and another if it's wood, and...
I get it.
Well, but the big thing is that your dad's going to send signals through the computer telling them which sphere they're supposed to pick. Dory, Susan, and Sam each have their own special code, and then they go, one at a time, and touch the right sphere with their noses.
I think I understand.
How about this? It's as if we say, Dory, go and pick out the 4th lightest sphere. Except we're telling them in the clicks and whistles that they use themselves, which normally we can't hear.
Sounds a little complicated.
Very. The computer acts as a sort of translator between us and them. Took your father a long time to figure out how to send even a simple instruction. See, their language, it's a lot different. It's a lot more complicated than ours.
Why don't you teach them English?
We tried. And we think they can say some words. But it's really hard for them to make the sounds. You see, I guess what we have to remember is that communication in their world is a lot different from ours.
But if Dad can get the computer to do this, does that mean that one day we'll be able to talk to them?
We don't know, but that's why we're here.
Introduction with Dr. Jeffrey Farris, our computer systems specialist, Danielle Fournier, our head trainer, and of course our 3 dolphins, Dory, Susan, and Sam. Now, this demonstration is designed primarily to show our ability to communicate via the computer with the 3 dolphins in the pool. Now, as well, and we feel with equal importance, it'll show the amazing ability of the dolphins to detect differences in returning sonar echoes that are as small as 3 millionths of a second apart. Ooh, how was that?
Perfect. All right, now. Danielle.
Here.
You can let them back into the main pool.
You got it.
Listen, Jeremy, I hope you don't mind when I have to bring Michael here. I can't get Mrs. Norris to come on Saturdays, and it's hard for me
to... No, it's no problem. He's always good when he's here. As a matter of fact, I find it amazing how well-behaved he is when he's near the dolphins.
Well, it's become a familiar place to him. He doesn't handle changes very well. Mm-hmm. You should have seen us trying to get him out of the car.
They're in the pool.
Okay, I'm running the signals.
All right, let's do it. What the hell's going on? They're not responding. Jeff, are you sure that...
Well, check the scopes. Well, we're definitely sending the right codes. Dory's number two sphere, Susan number four, Sam number five.
Well, they're just sitting there.
Maybe they know we're filming them.
Not funny, Danielle. There must be a malfunction at the pool. I bet they screwed up that underwater speaker again.
Well, it was working perfectly just a few minutes ago.
Michael grabbed the wire on number two sphere and he won't let go. Dory, for heaven's sake! Hey, Jeff, what kind of instructions are you giving them anyway? Dory just soaked us. Okay, come on, Michael. There's a good boy. Now let go of the wire. There's a good boy. Okay, everything's under control. Jeff, what are you telling them?
Hold on a minute, Danielle. We're trying to figure out what's wrong.
Michael, what are you doing, Michael? Michael! Michael!
Michael!
That's a good boy. I'm doing my best. He's really got a grip on it. I don't want to hurt him. And Susan's racing around the pool like she's... It's like they're a cheering section.
Do you realize what's happening? Michael's pulling on each stalk and spear in turn.
And they seem to know it.
Yes. First Dory, number two, then Susan, number four.
Now he's grabbing number five. There goes Sam around the pool.
He talked to them, didn't he? I told you he could.
But how?
You want to know?
Oh, you're crazy. You did it, huh? You showed us, Jeff. Look at them.
They reached them, the dolphins. I mean, he hasn't laughed since you...
This is the most exciting thing.
Lotion. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong, you beautiful son of a bitch.
Michael, I never really thought you had a chance. But now, we're going to make you better, son. We're going to make you better.
Daddy, we don't have to send them away. You're not going away, Michael. You're going to stay with us.
That's terrific. Yeah, we'll be waiting at poolside. Right. Okay, bye. All right, Paul.
Yes, Dr. Lawson.
As soon as you see them come in, start the cameras and
leave them running.
Have you got it?
Got it. No problem.
We all set?
Ooh, we better be. They'll be here in a few minutes.
You might have changed that much in 6 months.
Well, we'll know soon enough.
Hey, how does Jeff feel about all this?
It took a lot of convincing to get him to agree. I think the fact that Michael's doing so well at the school in Toronto has helped, though.
Hey, Jen, here, check out the monitor.
Hmm?
They know something's up.
Oh, they're as nervous as I am. Well, it won't be long. He'll be here soon.
Look at that!
Oh, that's quite a show they're putting on for you guys, huh?
They sure don't get that excited when they see me.
Well, what do you think, Michael? I think a lot of that is for your benefit.
Oh.
What?
Hello, Dorothy.
Hello.
Bet you don't remember their names.
Yes, I do.
Let's see.
Mm-hmm. Sam.
Yeah.
And
see?
And
Gory!
Oh, yay!
Gory!
That's right, Michael. That's right.
Go ahead, Michael. You can go right up to them. They like you.
Oh, again. See my friends.
That's incredible.
Jim, I can't believe he's come so far. 20.
You can see a difference almost every week. Even the therapists at the school in Toronto are amazed.
Do they have an explanation?
Well, they know so little about autism. That's the problem. They think it might be connected to a disturbance or damage in the left hemisphere of the brain.
Mm-hmm. And that's exactly my theory about Michael. You see, somehow, when the dolphins broke through to him, they must have caused a reaction in his brain or a jolt of some
Look,
kind.
He's going right up to them.
Jeremy.
No, let's just watch. Hmm?
Jeremy? You know what we agreed? If there's any chance...
Yeah, he's okay, Jeff.
As long as you understand, I won't allow him to be hurt.
No one's going to get hurt. Look at them. They adore him.
You know what I mean.
Look at his face. Do you think he remembers? I don't know, honey. I just don't know.
He's too near the edge of the pool.
Jeff, the boy's all right.
What's happening? I don't know, honey. They're just staring at each other.
Shh.
Michael, hey, Michael.
Shh, Miriam, let Michael
talk.
No,
you let her talk to him. Go ahead, Miriam.
Dad?
Okay, honey, go ahead.
Michael.
What did they say?
What?
Tell me what they said.
I don't know.
Yes, you do. Come on.
No, I don't.
You used to talk to them. Don't you remember? Come on, Michael.
No.
Yes, you do. They told you to do something. And you did it, remember? I saw you.
They were my friends.
Michael. All right, now, Michael, you try to tell us. Huh? Try to tell us. What did the dolphins say to you? You can tell me.
I don't know.
Jeremy, that's enough.
Michael, please try. Did they say hello? Did they tell you to do something? Did they? Michael,
that
please.
That is enough, Lawson.
Oh, no, see, I've got it. See, it's all wrong. We've got to duplicate the experiment.
No more. I'm not taking any more chances.
Oh, Jeff, please.
No. It's okay, son. It's okay, son.
I don't remember them ever being so quiet. Dr. Dawson?
Yeah, look, Miriam. Miriam, why don't you go and see how Michael's doing? Okay?
Thank you.
the dolphins say to Michael that afternoon 6 months ago? Did they mistake him, in his innocence, for one of their own kind, hailing him and bidding him wade out from his lonely island to be with them? And was it then that Michael laughed? Myth has it that dolphins rescue the shipwrecked, those lost at sea. Now, Michael can talk. He can love and know human love, but at a cost. His solitude, shattered forever. His lonely island and his momentary friendship vanished.
The Rescue by Rafael Vigo. Chuck Shamata starred as Dr. Jeffrey Ferris, with Beth Lisheron as Danielle, Stephen Hare as Dr. Jeremy Lawson, Chantal Rogers as Miriam Ferris, Aaron Smolinski as Michael Ferris, and Daniel Libman as the technician. Original music was composed and performed by Ron Cassett, and the sounds of the dolphins were provided by John and Tony Lilly of the Human Dolphin Foundation in Malibu, California. The sound engineers were Norm Hurley and Rick Fenton, with sound effects by Uta Schaffland, and the production assistant was Elaine Farner. The script editors were Barry Morgan and Sandra Rabinovich. The voice of introduction for Vanishing Point is David Calderisi, and the original musical theme is by John Roby. The Rescue was produced and directed at CBC Calgary by Greg Rogers. The executive producer of Vanishing Point is William Lane. Next week on Vanishing Point, we present an adaptation of a story by one of the most celebrated authors of our time, Jorge Luis Borges. Death and the Compass is a very unusual kind of detective story. It's adapted for CBC Radio by Alberto Manguel, whose recent anthology of fantastic literature, Blackwater, has already earned high praise in several countries. The CBC production features Eric House, Sandy Webster, Paul Soles, and Maya Ardal. Death and the Compass. Next week on Vanishing Point. Until then, this is Art Cuthbert, wishing you good night.